Hi, my name is Andreas Piotrowski. I studied mathematics and computer science in the 90s at the Johann Wolfgang Goethe University in Frankfurt, Germany, and my specialization was analytical number theory. Currently, I am by profession a software engineer. Besides my professional work, I didn't want to lose stronger connections with mathematics, and I decided in 2014 to create a non-commercial mathematical site called Book of Proofs. Book of Proofs' goal is to propagate the public knowledge of the axiomatic method, which is, in my opinion, a pillar of every science, but is not known as much as it deserves. My site also aims to encourage visitors and students to learn how to write and understand mathematical proofs and how to understand mathematical concepts. Very soon after I created the site, I started to look for possibilities to provide interactive widgets that would help visitors to play around with some mathematical concepts. I was glad to have found JSXGraph because it is, unlike some other tools, free, flexible, and can be easily integrated into web contents. In my presentation today, I want to show you how I use JSXGraph for visualization purposes, taking complex numbers as an example, because I think complex numbers are for many students a sealed book, and visualizing them may help to better understand what they really are. Let me start with explaining what the problem of visualizing complex numbers is. To better understand the problem, you can compare it to the way we can visualize real numbers. Usually, real numbers are visualized via a one-dimensional axis with an origin, point zero, and a scale of 1 unit, in which we can imagine single real numbers as arrows going from the origin to some given real number, for example, 2 or 3. Note that the arrows of negative numbers are the reversed arrows of positive numbers. Using JSXGraph, complex numbers are two-dimensional objects that can be visualized as points in a system of coordinates. Usually, we call the x-coordinate of a complex number the real and the y-coordinate of the complex number the imaginary part. As you can see, JSXGraph allows creating an interactive system of coordinates in which you can, for instance, select one particular complex number and better understand that its real and imaginary parts are simply the projections of the number to the x and y axis. So this is a nice but not really an impressive visualization. The advantage of interactive JSXGraph widgets can be shown when things get more complicated. For instance, when we visualize the addition or the subtraction of real numbers, then their addition would simply be two arrows strung together. The subtraction would be stringing of the first arrow with the reversed second arrow. Going back to the complex case now, JSXGraph can help us to visualize how addition works in the complex case. The interactivity demonstrates impressively, in my opinion, that when we add complex numbers, you just have to apply the parallelogram rule to get the sum of the complex number x and y. Taking x equals 2 and y equals minus 3, as in the real example before, we can see how the real case becomes merely a special case of the parallelogram rule. This shows how JSXGraph can help students to understand why the real part of a complex number is called its real part. Real numbers simply turn out to be a special case of complex numbers in which the imaginary part is zero. Things get even more interesting, in my opinion, in the case of multiplication. For the multiplication, the arrow-based model in the real case is not so obvious. Here, pupils or students have sometimes problems and have to remember the so-called sign rules of multiplication. For instance, when you multiply two real numbers with different signs, the result is always negative. Surprisingly, JSXGraph helps students to better understand the sign rules in the real case if we visualize multiplication of complex numbers. To better understand what is happening when we multiply complex numbers, it is instructive, in my opinion, to introduce polar coordinates of a complex number. As already mentioned, in the Cartesian system, a complex number has two coordinates, the real and the imaginary part. In the polar coordinates, a complex number also has two coordinates, but the first number is its distance of the origin, from the origin, excuse me, which is called its absolute value, and the second number is its angle with respect to the x-axis, which is called its argument. In this example widget, JSXGraph helps students to better understand the difference between the Cartesian and the polar coordinates. Now, going back to multiplication. When multiplying two complex numbers, we simply have to multiply the lengths of their absolute values and to add the angles of their arguments. I promised you to show how JSXGraph helps to get a better understanding of the sign rules. Pupils and students otherwise have to learn by heart. When we choose, for example, 2 times minus 3, we see that 2 has an argument of 0 degrees and minus 3 has the argument of 180 degrees. Thus, the resulting product is the sum of both arguments, which is again 180 degrees. Another interesting possibility is to let the students experiment with this JSXGraph widget and to find out which complex number has the property that if multiplied with itself, the product will be minus 1. Here, again, the argument of minus 1 is 180 degrees. And thus, this complex number has to have a 90 degrees argument. So it is the half of 180. The distance of minus 1 to 0, to the origin, is 1. And thus, the distance of this complex number we are looking for to 0 must also be 1. Thus, what we call the imaginary unit is the only complex number whose square is minus 1, or expressed differently, the square root of minus 1 equals the imaginary unit. This, in my opinion, helps very much to understand what an imaginary unit might be. JSX graph can also help to visualize complex valued functions. Let me say what a function is. A function is in mathematics a rule mapping each element of one set into exactly one element of another set. This is indicated in the left side of the drawing, where you can see two real intervals, one marked orange and one marked red. The function f is mapping each point x of the orange interval into exactly one point f of x of the red interval. Now, if you imagine that the point x is moving from one end of the orange interval to the other end, the image f of x might also move in one or in both directions of the red interval. It is easy to draw function graphs in JSX graph for the real case. This process is usually visualized by drawing all points with the coordinates x and f of x into a planar system of coordinates in which x and y axes are perpendicular to each other, which is visible on the right side. Now, just like in the real case, when we had a function mapping every orange real number to exactly one red real number, in the complex case, a complex valued function is mapping every pair of orange coordinates into a pair of red coordinates. This cannot be visualized in a single planar graph. What we need are two planes, the so-called Z-plane of orange coordinates and the so-called W-plane of red coordinates. When a point Z is moving along a curve in the Z-plane, a continuous function f will usually map this movement into another curve in the W-plane. This principle of mapping the Z-plane into the W-plane can be visualized using JSX graph, and I want to show you this based on the complex exponential function. Unlike in the real case when we can map only one-dimensional intervals, in the complex case we can look at what happens if we map whole regions of the complex plane. In this case, we see how the complex exponential function maps a circular region, green, and a segment, red, from the Z-plane into the W-plane. For instance, we can experiment using JSX graph with segments whose imaginary part is zero to see that it is indeed the real valued exponential function. On the other hand, JSX graph helps us to experiment for which red segments in the Z-plane the image in the W-plane becomes a spiral or even a circle. When we move the vertical segment between minus pi to pi, its image is always a circle, but only if we position the segment in the Z-plane in such a way that its real part becomes zero. The image circle will have then the radius of 1. For instance, moving the Z segment vertically leads to the rotation of the image circle. This leads us to another important insight: the relationship between the complex exponential function and the trigonometric functions. The vertical movement of the segments means that we are multiplying the imaginary unit by a scalar. This is what we call the sine of a real function. In this JSX graph widget, I combined the visualization of a real-valued sine function, which is shown above, with a visualization of a complex-valued exponential function, which is shown below. As you can see, I can now move the value of x and observe how the real sine function and the complex function change simultaneously, and why the real sine can be defined as the imaginary part of the complex exponential function. Of course, similar analogy can be drawn between the complex exponential function and the real cosine function, but I won't show you the cosine JSX graph example today. My last slide is addressing the issue of how JSX graph can be embedded into web content. In my case, I had to solve the problem that articles on my site are written using a markdown syntax combined with the syntax of MathJax for mathematical formulae. Most JSX graph widgets require not only the layout, but also when you have interactive JSX graph widgets, they required JavaScript code. The solution was that I had to tweak the markdown procedure used in my site not to strip selected HTML tags, like the div tags, for example, which would be otherwise stripped. Moreover, using the convention of three paragraph signs, it was possible not only to insert JavaScript code, but also to execute it. Of course, as a developer, you have to make sure that this code is not shown in the article, but executed. Otherwise, your JSX graph widgets will not function properly. Okay, this is all I wanted to show you today. In summary, I wanted to get you an idea of how interactive JSX graphs can increase insight of students into seemingly complicated mathematical concepts and how they can be integrated into websites. I also provide you with the links of some interactive widgets shown in my presentation, but also with some other examples. I hope you enjoyed this first presentation in the conference. Thank you very much for your interest. If you have some questions, I stay ready for them in the upcoming discussion. I wish you a good and insightful conference.